The Canola School on realagriculture.com is brought to you by BSF Canada and Invigor Hybrid Canola.
Karen Oosterhuis here with realagriculture.com. I am back here today with another Canola School episode, and I have here with me Carlo Van Herk, who is with Farming Smarter. How's it going today?
Pretty good. How about yourself?
We're doing good. So we're out here today to look at one of your trials. You're working on strip tilling in canola. Do you want to tell me some of the highlights, what you guys are looking at this year?
For sure. So a big thing with planting canola always is residue management. So when there's lots of residue left on the ground, there's an improper seed bed for canola. As canola likes a nice warm and full soil contact, especially on such a small canola seed. So having a proper seed bed, which is warmed up and is a little less moisture as well, is always a lot better for the plant to emerge. And of course, better emergence always means better growth, better yield, and also better weed competition.
So what was the difference you found? You did trials between conventional no-till and strip-till. What were some of the main differences you were seeing?
So the no-tilled plots definitely did the worst out of the seeding, and the fully cultivated did the best. The strip-tilled was, I'd say, about right in the middle, which is sort of where I expected it. It received a little better seed bed, and it had some more moisture from the outer rows, except it wasn't a full till, so it did not benefit from it completely.
Now, you looked at some soil moistures as well. You put different probes in the different types. Do you want to talk about what you found there?
Yeah, so we have soil moisture probes installed in the ground. They went a meter down. We installed them in the no-till, the full-till, and the strip-tilled plots. And the results were that the cultivated plots were drier up on the top, and then they got wetter till about 15 centimeters, and then they stayed about the same moisture all the way down to a full meter. And then the strip-tilled and the no-tilled plots were a little wetter on the surface, and they got wetter as we went down to about 20 centimeters, and then they got a lot drier on the way down. So it created quite an interesting curve where the cultivated and the no-tilled plots really crossed right over the no-tilled plots. Usually strip-tilling happens in the fall. So then of course, during the winter, you have all your wind erosion. However, this year we strip-tilled in the spring. So we didn't really have that much of an issue. But of course, with the wind came the hot and the dry weather. So that made for some really interesting results as well.
Okay, and what did you find with weed competition as well?
The no-tilled plots definitely had more weeds than the fully cultivated. The strip-till is right in the middle. Even now when the canola is in full flower, well, it's past full flower, there's some weeds that are coming almost to the top of the canola plants in the no-tilled plots, while the cultivated plots just have some tiny little seedlings, which will definitely get choked out by the large canopy cover that canola provides. Yeah, so one very interesting thing this year, especially since after seeding, we had such a big temperature range. We had one night of frost, and then I think it was the next week, we had like 35 degree weather. So we noticed that the cultivated plots, they got pretty chilly that night of the frost, while the no-tilled and the strip-tilled plots, both of them, they stayed about a degree and a half warmer than the fully cultivated plots. And of course, the same goes in the opposite direction. The very hot days, the cultivated plots get hotter than the strip-tilled and the no-tilled plots.
So what did you find with emergence as well with the different trials?
Yeah, so the canola definitely struggled in the no-tilled plots, as where we had our plots right here, there was a lot of residue left on the ground. The no-tilled really struggled to get a full proper emergence. The strip-till did a lot better, and the cultivated did just a little bit better than the strip-tilled yet.
So of course there's going to be some challenges as well. If you're a farmer that's kind of looking at doing this for the first year, what are some of your recommendations?
Well, really the main thing is with strip-tilling, you have your 2 inches or 2 to 3 inches of your strip-tilled row. As long as you go through with your seeder again, make sure you got your GPS set up properly, that you're seeding directly into the strip-tilled rows. Otherwise, there's no point in strip-tilling if you're not even going to seed into those tilled rows.
Absolutely. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.